Welcome to this first Luminar tutorial and celebration giveaway. More and more people get annoyed by Adobe's subscription system and don't want to pay a monthly fee for a software they don't all that regularly use or even earn their money with. The good news is there are alternatives to Lightroom. My name is Wolf Amri, wolf.amri on Instagram, and in this video I will show you how well Luminar works. And we will also give away Luminar licenses at the end of the video. Okay, starting out, I want to mention that I heard quite a few people saying Luminar was only good for replacing the sky. Like in this image where I placed our Vienna town hall in the mountains, or in this where a thunderstorm suddenly appeared behind our parliament. The truth, however, is totally different. Luminar is a highly capable software for portraits, landscapes, and whatnot. To be honest, I thought the same when I first used Luminar. I used it as I would use Lightroom and was a bit disappointed. But let's face it, using a software the way you would use another one that was optimized for that workflow isn't the best idea. So let me tell all of you who are saying Luminar is only good for replacing the sky, you are using it the wrong way. I want to use this first Luminar lesson to make you aware that this piece of software is amazing and show you what you can do with it with just very few clicks, because Luminar is AI powered. AI standing for artificial intelligence. Using it like Lightroom would be a waste of resources. Using it the way it is intended to will give you great, maybe even better results in less time. In the next lessons, I will then guide you step by step through all the tools and settings in Luminar. Okay, let's get started. First of all, I will edit this image of a wedding we recently shot and transform it into this image. The conditions were not ideal, but we wanted to get these pillars in the back that were characteristic for the location. So we put the couple in the open shade and exposed for the highlights so that we don't overexpose the pillars in the back. If you want to know my camera settings, I'll quickly open the info module for you, and here is all the info. The only thing that I will do in the editing area you would probably do most of your Lightroom edits in, which is this part, is brighten the midtones and shadows of the image. I will do that in the curves. More on curves in a separate video, because they are a really powerful tool but a bit advanced. And I will bring the exposure up a bit to get that nice and airy look. Clicking on the eye icon, we will already see quite an improvement. But the magic hasn't even started yet. I will now change to the Creative tab, and in the subtabs I will go to Color Styles LUT. Here you find an array of beautiful color styles that are built in into Luminar. Nothing you have to buy. I will choose Santa Barbara. Well, and I would say we already have a pretty usable natural image, no? That was just a few clicks, but we are not there yet. Many of you like that light and airy look, and guess what? Luminar has specific subtab for that. Let's change to the Portrait tab and then to High Key. All I will do is drag the amount slider up to, let's say, 40. Isn't that similar to what many of you are going for? Let me just turn the High Key tab on and off to show you the difference. You can do that with every subtab, by the way, or you can reset the subtab if you wish. And now to the AI tabs. AI Portrait Enhancer. What about brightening up the face? All I need to do is drag the face slider and Luminar will automatically know where the faces are. Same with the AI Skin Enhancer. Luminar knows where the skin is, not only in the face, but also on the arms. Even if I drag the slider all the way up, it still looks rather natural compared to other tools that are available. And it works automatically. I still feel it is a little bit too much, so I will dial it back a bit. Okay, to finish this image, I feel it is a little bluish. I like it warmer. I could now go back to the LUTs and choose a different one. For example, Miami, which has a more yellow-greenish tone. But scrolling through them, they all work with this image. It is not like Lightroom where you have presets or profiles and you can only use a handful, but the others look a bit crappy. They all look good. And the other option of giving the image a warmer tone would of course be to go to the basic light tab and change the color temperature to a warmer tone. And while I'm here, I could add a little contrast. And that's it. Without changing much of the settings you would rely on if you use Lightroom, which would be this lights up tab, we managed to get from here to there. And despite that massively different look, we didn't get any noise. But we didn't even touch the denoise sub tab yet. And most of all, it was really quick. It would have been even quicker if we didn't explain it on the way. I bet you now start to realize how powerful Luminar really is. And it will get even better in a second. But if you are already convinced, I'll post a link in the description that will give you a discount if you purchase Luminar from that link. I'm honest with you, it will get me some affiliate earnings, which will help me create new lessons. So it's a win-win. But you see, I'm not lying here to promote a software. You saw what it can do, and it gets even better. Back to editing my wedding images. Can it get even quicker? I could paste these settings to another image of that wedding series. I can either use copy, Command or Control plus C, and paste Command and Control plus V. Or I create my own Luminar look by clicking Save New Look. In my opinion, these presets in Luminar adapt much better to the individual image than copying and pasting settings in Lightroom. I often feel in Lightroom that using my own presets only work for certain images. In Luminar, on the other hand, it gives you a really good starting point, and with a few small tweaks, like in this case lowering the brightness and adapting the white balance, you will get a style that makes the images a perfect match and creates a series. Now that the bride is looking into the camera, let me try something else. You may know Esther the Bride from our photography course lesson, The 5 Factors of Background Blur. I will link you to that at the end of the video. Okay, I will zoom in and go to the portrait enhancer again. Here we have the eye enhancer and the dark circles removal. Not that Esther's eyes need some enhancement, but let's just drag that up. Around 40 and around 70 on the dark circles removal. And then let's have a look at the before and after. Okay, we still have that face light turned on. We pasted that from the other image, if you remember. So Luminar found the face and brightened it up, even though the face was on a totally different part of the image. Yes, Luminar is a bit slower when you go from one image to the other. That is because the AI algorithm works. But you easily catch up or even speed up overall with having less work on the images. Let's just turn off the face light to better concentrate on the eye effect. Off and on. Off and on. Beautiful, right? I will just dial that face light back in before I show you the next example. I'll copy and paste the settings I used with this image to that image. I don't even have to tweak it a lot. It is usable as is because usually Luminar finds the face in the images and does its AI thing. Doing that in Lightroom would mean I would have to use the adjustment brush and the skin smoother effect and paint on the images wherever the skin is. Here it is, just copy, paste, and do some white balance and exposure tweaks. And now I will even copy the settings of the images where Esther is looking into the camera onto this image, which has a totally different lighting. This image is almost usable as is. Not only did Luminar find the skin and the eyes, the whole edit is pretty good. Let me try the same in Lightroom. So I copy the settings of this image and paste it onto that one. Not only does the skin look much better in Luminar, the images in general are a better match and create a beautiful series. Do I want to bash Lightroom? Not at all. I still use it, but Luminar offers a stunning performance for much less money. And I'm considering doing most of my edits, particularly of people, in Luminar from now on. Let me invite you to see for yourself. The link in the description also leads you to a 7-day trial. Take one of your images and follow my steps in this video to get you a stunning result. And now to our giveaway. We have 5 licenses of Luminar to give away altogether. We will do 2 today and 3 next week. If you want to know how to take part, have a look at this video. Our good luck fairy of the day will be Little Foxy. Today's winners are Laura Evie Ochoa and Rodolin Kabitak. Congrats! See you in the next video!